Good evening, everyone. So we are a group of four members from CSEA third year of BPPMT going to give a presentation on the topic of parsing. So I will request my group members to kindly introduce themselves.
Hello, myself Aniket Kumar Sao, University Roll Number 8131.
Hello, I am Anand Kashyap, University Roll Number 8134.
Hello, myself Anupam Shah, Roll 8126.
Hello, myself Abhishek Sharma, my university roll number is 8146.
So, going into the topic of parsing, we need to know what is parser. So, parser is basically a compiler that is used to break the data into smaller elements coming from lexical analysis phase. So, the syntax analyzer follows production rules defined by means of context-free grammar. The way the production rules are implemented divides parsing into two types. So the first one is top-down parsing. So going to the top-down parsing, the top-down parsing is known as recursive parsing or predictive parsing. Bottom-up parsing is used to construct a parse tree for input string. So in top-down parsing, the parsing starts from the start symbol and transform it into the input symbol. So the parse representation of input string ACDB is you can see here on the screen. This is the representation, parse tree representation of the string. So moving to the next type, that is bottom up parsing, I will request Anand to kindly present.
Now let's move to the types of top down parsing. First one is recursive descent parsing. It is a common form of top down parsing. It is called recursive as it uses recursive procedures to process the input. Recursive descent parsing suffers from backtracking. Now the second type of the top-down parsing is backtracking. It means one derivation of production fails, the syntax analyzer restarts the process using different rules of same production. This technique may process the input string then once to determine the right production.
So moving to the bottom up parsing, which will be presented by Aniket.
Bottom up parsing is also known as shift reduced parsing. Bottom up parsing is used to construct a parse tree for an input string. In the bottom up parsing, the parsing starts with the input symbol and construct the parse tree up to the starting symbol by tracing out the rightmost derivation of a string in reverse. Bottom-up parsing is classified into various parsing. These are as follows: shift-reduced parsing, operator-precedence parsing, table-driven LR parsing, LR1, SLR1, CLR1, and LALR1.
So, moving into the features of bottom-up parsing, which will be presented by Abhishek.
Coming to the features of bottom-up parsing. Bottom-up parsing starts from the leaf nodes of a tree and works in upward direction till it reaches the root node. Here we start from a sentence and then apply production rules in reverse manner in order to reach the start symbol. The image given below depicts the bottom-up parsers available.
Okay, so we are going to see some gate level questions regarding the topic parsing. So moving to the first question, that is the grammar S2ASA BSC. The grammar, what will be the grammar? So here are the options: LL1 but not LR1, LR1 but not LR1, both LL1 and LR1, neither LL1 nor LR1. So the correct option for this will be C, that is both LL1 and LR1. This is because all are mutually disjoint, that is no common terminal between them. The given grammar is LL1. As the grammar is LL1, so it will also be LR1. As LR parsers are powerful than LL1 parsers, and all LL1 grammar are also LR1. So the option C is correct. So moving to the question 2, which will be explained by Anand.
Now let's move on to the second question. The question is as follows:
Which one of the following is a top down parser?
The option A is recursive descent parser. Option B is operator precedence parser. Option C is an LRK parser. And option D is an LRK parser. The correct option is answer A. Now let's move on to the explanation of this question. In the top down parsing, the parsing starts from the start symbol and transform it into the input symbol. Recursive descent parsing is LL1 parsing, which is a type of the top down parsing.
So moving to the third question, that will be explained by Abhishek.
Yeah, coming to the next question, question number 3. The question is, match all items in group 1 with correct options from those given in group 2. Group 1 contents are regular expression, push down automata, data flow analysis, register allocation, and group 2 contents are syntax analysis, code generation, lexical analysis, and code optimization. And the answer is option B. Now come up to the explanation part. Okay, regular expressions are used in lexical analysis. Push down automata is related to context free grammar, which is related to syntax analysis. Data flow analysis is done in code optimization, and register allocation is done in code generation.
Okay. So moving to the fourth question, which will be explained by Aniket.
Which of the following statement is false? Number A, an unambiguous grammar has same leftmost and rightmost derivation. Number B, an LL1 parser is a top-down parser. C, LALR is more powerful than SLR. D, an ambiguous grammar can never be LR for any K. And the correct answer is A, which is an unambiguous grammar has same leftmost and rightmost derivation. Let's move on to that explanation. Since a grammar is ambiguous, if there exists a string such that the grammar has more than one left-hand derivation for S, we could also come up with more than one rightmost derivation for a string to prove the above proposition, but not both the of right and leftmost. Since LL parser is top-down parser, leftmost derivation is expanding and rightmost derivation is compressing or bottom-up thing. LALR is more powerful than SLR, even when both the same LR0 states, due to the fact that SLR checks for look ahead by looking at first and follow from the grammar after constructing its parse table. An unambiguous grammar can never be LRK for any K, because LRK algorithms are not designed to handle ambiguous grammar. Let's move on to the fifth question. An LALR1 parser for a grammar G can have shift reduce SR conflicts if and only if. Option A, the SLR1 parser for G has SR conflicts. Option B, the LR1 parser for G has SR conflicts. Option C, the LR0 parser for G has SR conflicts. Option D, the LALR1 parser for G has reduced conflicts. And the answer is B, which is the LR1 parser for G has SR conflicts. Since if LR1 parser has two states I and J with item A to A dot BP comma X and A to A dot BP comma Y respectively, where X and Y are look ahead symbol, then as these items are same with respect to their first component, they can be merged together and form one state, let's say K. Here we have to take union of look ahead symbol. After merging state, K will have one single items as A to ABP X comma Y. This way, LR states are formed. That is after merging the states of LR1.
So with this, we come to the end of our presentation. Hope you liked our presentation. Thank you.
Very good. Excellent presentation. I like it. Just a minute. Yeah, very good presentation. Thank you, Abhishek, Anupam, Anand.
Thank you, sir.
One thing I like you, you touched on the bottom-up parser, which is the toughest one, but you can understand first the parse table, how to create parse table in the LL1 parsing table. From there, that will be heavily used in bottom-up parsing also. Whenever a grammar is LL1, definitely that can be more powerful, means LR1 is more powerful, means it can recognize more grammar. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.